Welcome to Tuscaloosa, Alabama, where legends are made and titles are won. Bryant-Denny Stadium, home of the Alabama Crimson Tide. Coaches like to say no game is more important than any other. When you have a couple of top 10 teams ready to square off, yeah, that one carries a little more weight. As we'll see, the number 10 team in the country, the Missouri Tigers, taking on the sixth-ranked team in the land, the Alabama Crimson Tide. For EA Sports College Football, Reese Davis with you alongside David Pollack and Jesse Palmer. And guys, can't wait to get this one started. Alabama about to kick off to get this game underway. He'll bring it back from inside his five. Didn't find any crease in that kickoff coverage, and he'll be stopped at the 17. The Tigers offense will start this game off. And all eyes will be on this man because he is electrifying every time he touches the ball.
I mean, so much fun to watch. Can hit home runs, can make big plays. Everything in this offense starts with that grown man.
What I really like about him, too, is he's versatile, right? He can carry the rock, he can catch the football, he's good at blocking. This guy stays on the field for a reason.
Didn't get much done on that first play of the drive. It's second and 11. The give to the back. Can't get him to the ground. And that defense pushing him out of bounds after a short gain.
I think tackling is about effort most of the time. It's about how much passion, how much physicality you can bring to get your guy on the ground. Refuse not to get him on the ground. That's not a big back. You got to get that guy on the ground. You can't let him pick up an extra couple yards and stay ahead of the sticks.
Looking for a man. It's Cook. Fires to the right. He's got it. Solid work and execution there. They'll have a first down as they mark it at the 40.
And listen, the defense knew coming into this one, they were going to target him early and often. He is a weapon, and there's no mystery where the quarterback's going to be looking on critical down and distances. Let's see how they're able to cover him throughout the rest of this game.
Here's a quick throw out to the left. And they pick up just a few on that completion.
Ooh, and that was close for the offense. They try to go wide receiver screen. They're counting on that receiver beating that defender. Wasn't able to make a miss that time, but if I'm on offense, I'm going back to that play later.
You can barely hear yourself thinking here as they're trying to get this defense off to a good start. And the defense stops him just short of the first down. Maybe needed a few more chain links to move the sticks. Here comes his home crowd as the defense tries to get off the field on third down. They'll try to pick it up on the ground. He's got enough to move the chains, and they'll spot it at the 47.
And I think on that last run play on third down here early in the game, they're making a statement that we believe we're the more physical team, and we're going to run the football even if you know it's coming at you. Nice job. They've got the ball at midfield. I expect to see more run plays coming up.
They're going to ride this running back. Nowhere to run on that one. He loses four on the carry. That linebacker was a heat-seeking missile, and the heat that he sought was the ball carrier.
Yeah, great job, great feel. Linebackers are making all the calls in the defense and understanding when I need to come through that gap and come through with bad intention. Those guys are usually 245 pounds of heat-seeking missile.
The give to the running back from the shotgun. They bring him down, and he's going to lose a yard on that one.
Well, you live by the blitz, you die by the blitz. That time, the defense called it at the perfect time. The linebacker able to make the stop on a short game.
And from the offense's perspective, that's probably making a little something out of nothing. Now the eighth play of the opening drive, but this time facing third and long. Looking to throw, it's Cook. And there was nowhere to go for this quarterback, and down he goes.
On third and long, you know what's coming. It's exactly where you want to get an offense. The passing game has to come out. You go nickel, bring some more speed on the field,
their first punt of the afternoon. Wouldn't call it a shank, but I don't think he'll include it on his greatest hits. He gets it up to the 34-yard line before he stopped, and that's where the offense will set up shop. So Alabama's offense will take the field for the first time. Here are our impact players for this game, and it goes beyond executing an assignment to make an impact in the game.
Yeah, obviously we were talking to both coaching staffs this week, and we asked them who needs to step up and play well. They immediately pointed to these guys right here. They are the key for their respective teams.
Yeah, they don't always show up in the box score, but these are the guys that are the leaders. These are the guys getting everybody organized and have to play well for their team to succeed.
The offense setting up shop at the 46, first and 10. Use the play fake, now to throw. It's caught. Slammed to the ground, but not before he gets the first down. The evolution of the Alabama offense has always been built around what does the quarterback do best, and this guy's doing a lot of things well.
And we've seen some sensational ones. And to your point, I like that. Jalen Hurts, really good runner. They built it around his feet. You know, Bryce Young, really good passer. Tua Tagovailoa, really good passer. More about the passing game, explosive passing plays. So they'll do whatever it takes to win.
And that's just a great individual effort by the wide receiver. He catches this ball way short of the sticks, but because he's able to make the defender miss, now he's able to get the extra yards and turn that into an explosive play.
The Crimson Tide comes to the line with a first and 10. Out of the gun, the running back has it. Not a whole lot of room as he gets a couple inside the 30 to the 29.
And offenses want to continue to feature the run. They want balance. Even if it's not super successful, you can take it a little bit at a time just to keep that defense honest.
After picking up a couple at second and 8. Hand off from the gun. Not much room. A pickup of 2 down to the 28. A little less room to work with now as the ball's at the 28 and it's 3rd and long. Back to throw, it's Milroe. Looking to the big tight end. All kinds of room to throw that one in there.
And a really good job by the quarterback being very decisive. He saw his matchup, he went for it, he attacked it, got the positive gain. I would say he's going to find that guy a few more times today.
Alabama pushing the tempo. Running back searching for a hole. Pulled down after picking up 5 to the 6-yard line.
Hey, 5 to 6 yards a pop. I don't know if you guys are really good at math, but that usually equals a first down every couple carries. So don't forget about the run game. Keep them honest and count that rock.
Operating in the red zone here on second down. Wide receiver coming across in motion. Now on the move. He pushes his way down to the 4 as they get closer and closer.
And you can tell the QB wants to run. He's going to be a big part of the game plan. And the defense really, really understands that. I got to understand. And more importantly, when I get a lick on this cat, I got to take it. Like, not dirty, not cheap shots, but end of the plays, when I can be physical and really make him feel me, I think that'll always bode well in the fourth quarter.
Just threw that one away to avoid disaster.
Well, on third and short in field goal range, they dial up the pass play. Quarterback was trying to get through his progressions. There was just simply nobody open. Couldn't make an accurate enough throw. Ball falls incomplete. Now setting up a big decision here on fourth down.
They'll play it safe and try for 3. From the right hash, and this distance makes that angle not quite so severe. And this one splits the uprights. And with that, they break the seal on the scoring. It's 3-0.
This is a team that really prides themselves on starting fast. We've seen that before. And here they are playing at home today. Nice job on the opening drive. Lots of poise, good emotion. They don't get the touchdown they would have liked, but they kick a nice field goal. They've got the lead. Head coach has to be happy with it.
They were able to get a field goal on the board, and now they'll kick it away. On the run from inside his own five. And the returner runs out of real estate as he goes down. Mizzou has it back in the offense coming out on the field. They reached deep in the playbook, used almost all of them, it seemed, Jesse, and still ended up having to punt last time.
And I think on this next drive, David, you can go back to some of the stuff that worked that last drive, too. Find the things that you had success with. You just got to be able to build on it a little bit.
And just break that extra tackle, you know, make that extra play, make the guy miss, put a drive together so you can finish with some points.
With a first down, they'll snap it from the 32. The give to the back. Good job running tough and behind his pads as he gets up to the 38-yard line. Six-yard pickup on first down leaves him with second and four. From the gun, they'll give it on the inside. Wrestled down at the 43 after getting five.
Well, there we go. We finally see some life in this offense running the football. Nice game to pick up the first down. Got to get more of that going moving forward because they have not run it well.
They move the chains on the ground. Now another first down. They're getting this guy lathered up. He's dropped behind the line of scrimmage. That'll be a loss of three.
Linebackers in today's football, obviously, guys have gotten smaller. They got to play in space more, cover fast guys out on the perimeter. But how about this linebacker coming downhill and making a physical tackle in the hole?
Last play was a near disaster. Now dealing with second and 13. They'll run it. A strong tackle and wrap up from the junior.
And those physical runs take a toll. It might not be a big game now, but down the road, third, fourth quarter, late in the ball games, they tend to turn into bigger runs.
Decibels rising as the crowd gets behind this defense on third down. Wants to throw. It's Cook. Looking down the middle. Got his man. Lots of green grass as he gets it to the 31.
Nice play design on that one. You make it easy for your quarterback, too, because it's easy to see what's happening right in front of you. Over the middle of the field, you can see where defenders are dropping. You can see where the soft spots are in zone coverage. And just a really nice job by the QB locating his guy and making an accurate throw.
They'll give it to the back. Not much working there. It'll be second and nine.
Run game is good. Balance is good. Now listen, if the run game isn't good, then you got to pass the football a little bit more. But sometimes you got to keep them honest, take them chunk by chunk.
Didn't get much on first down. It's second and nine. Looking for space. It's Carroll. Picks up the first down. And a really nice run and pick up there before the defense avoided disaster and stopped the really big play.
And another nice gain by the offense. All right, defense, we got to change something up here. They're putting a big drive together, play after play, having a lot of success. How do we break the rhythm? How do we give them something that can create a tackle for a loss or a sack or something to get momentum back on my side?
They'll pick up four, second and six coming. So Alabama takes the lead into the quarter break. We put one in the books. Let's have a look at our game summary. Now to see if these guys can get back in the game in the second quarter. Going to work in the red zone, they can't pick up the first down without getting it into the end zone. They'll run it from the gun. They bring him down, and he's going to lose a yard on that one.
Great job of contained by this defense. And in order to do that, the end man on the line of scrimmage defense defensively has got to be able to set the point and force the football back into traffic. And that's exactly what happened.
This crowd knows when to bring it. On third down, he drops to throw. Moves away as he feels pressure.
And this is why defensive coordinators lose sleep at night, because guys like this have the football in their hand almost every single play. Third down, nothing open. He makes it happen himself. Now set up with a great scoring opportunity with first and goal.
Missouri comes up with a first and goal. They'll try to get it in with the run. He's got it down to the 1 yard line right on the doorstep of Pater. Defense trying to come up with a stop on second and goal. He'll pull it on the read. He's knocked down in the backfield. He'll lose a couple. Man down on the play as the officials take a break to let him be checked out. So loud it's rattling your fillings on third and goal. Dropping back, it's Cook. And he's got it! Touchdown, Missouri! You want to keep your offense on the field? Wear down the defense? Put that tape on and show it in a clinic. That's the way it's done.
And as a defense, man, there's nothing more demoralizing. You can handle it when you give up three, but to give up the touchdown at the end of a long drive, you're already exhausted. You've already been punked the whole way down the field. Man, that's frustrating.
Lining up to tack one more onto that lead. And the extra point is good, and it's a 4-point lead. That is what they mean when they say ball control, a 14-play touchdown drive. And they finish it up with a 3-yard scoring toss. About to kick it off after punching it in for the touchdown. On the move from inside his five. Nice job executing all of the assignments as they put a stop to that return at the 22. Here comes that Alabama offense. And to settle for the chip shot field goal last time, Jesse, they'd love for this one to pay off bigger.
Yeah, it just comes down to execution, too. Did a nice job out in the field, stalled a little bit once they got down to the goal line, so they just need to be a little bit more crisp here.
Yeah, and listen, I think the first part was the most important part. You got to put the drive together first to get down there. Now, when we get down there, focus on execution and getting 6 points.
Big play to start this drive. Now they'll snap it from the 39. Looking for a crease. It's Haynes. And he's able to bounce off one tackle for a solid pickup.
And as an offensive coordinator, you don't need the perfect play with this guy as your running back. He's going to make the play perfect for you because he makes everybody miss. Spin moves, hurdles, stiff arms, speed, whatever it takes to move the sticks and score a touchdown.
Good spot after that 7-yard pickup on first down. It's second and three. From the gun, the running back looking for room. The Tide will get the first down.
Really good-looking run. You know, think about the legacy Alabama has in the running back position. It's ridiculous. Mark Ingram won a Heisman, obviously. Derrick Henry, Josh Jacobs. I'm going to go back to Sean Alexander, who I played against back in the day, too. All these guys had speed. All these guys had vision and quickness. And this guy right here, he has all of those traits himself. Just another big-time talent in the Crimson Tide backfield.
Using the back as a receiver on the screen. And they'll shove him out of bounds after the short gain.
Things have to come together perfectly for a screen to work for big yardage. And they were close. You could tell that almost busted, but they just got wrapped up, got a little bit of yardage, but they really wanted that one to be a big game.
Offense in a bunch formation. Back to throw. It's Milroe trying to get to him. Trying to escape and get it himself. Nifty little scamper on this one. Enough for the first down, and he slides in safely.
You know, QBs want to make those big plays. They want to put up the big stats. But when nothing's there, sometimes you just tuck the ball, get a minimal gain. I like the slide, by the way, too. Get down and don't take a big hit.
Alabama comes to the line with first and 10. Looking to move it through the air. Finds his tight end. The modest gain on the completion really shows why you want to run the zone. Make them execute and rally to the ball.
100%. Zone eyes on the quarterback. I see him throw the football, break on it, go make tackles, live to fight another down.
Line getting set on second down. They'll leave it with him. Bulldoze ahead. He's down at the 18 after picking up 5.
I think they called that knowing they weren't going to hit a home run. So why would you call it that? Well, you call it so third down becomes an easier down. It's not third and long where I have to pass the football. Now all options on the table.
The Crimson Tide snaps it from the red zone. They'll try to bully their way for the first. He'll get that one all the way down to the 4-yard line before he stops.
It's a really nice job of the offense mixing it up on this drive. We've seen some nice plays throwing it, and how about that one running it too? Great push up front.
Alabama comes to the line with a first and goal. Wide out in motion. Using his feet. And he'll glide his way in for the score. Touchdown, Crimson Tide!
Like having an extra running back in your backfield. This quarterback is magic. When he decides to keep the football, he can make people look absolutely silly. He shows you on that play.
On to attempt the try. And the extra point gives him a 3-point lead at 10-7. So it's a 77-yard touchdown drive, and they finish it off with the score from the 4. About to kick it away after scoring the touchdown. And he takes this from inside the 5. Not a lot of space to be found. Good hustle by the coverage team, and they stop him at the 21. Missouri has the offense ready to go on the field. After standing on the sideline and watching that long touchdown drive, they really need to put something together to give their defense a rest.
And that's a real thing, man. Like, you've played a lot of plays, you get worn out, you need a chance to go decompress the sideline, get some oxygen. Palmer now is on this offense.
Yeah, this is the definition of complementary football, because it's a two-pronged problem. You've got to score points and answer, but you've also got to take your time and give your defense an opportunity to get their win.
Looking to pass, it's Cook. Makes the grab on the left. Finally run out of bounds, but he has this offense rolling with a first down.
And that's why if you're the offensive coordinator, you've got to find as many ways as possible to get this guy going. Just get him the ball close to the line of scrimmage. Doesn't need to be a throw deep down the field. He's so dynamic when he has the ball in his hands. You saw it right there.
It's first and 10 from the 38-yard line. One running back in the backfield, and he has it. Nowhere to run on that one. He loses 4 on the carry. So you get stuffed on first down. You had an idea of what you wanted to do on second, but I'm guessing it's back to the drawing board now.
Yeah, you got to figure out who you are and what you are. What's your next best play? Or what is the defense going to do? They've been aggressive? Okay, well, if they've been aggressive, I'm going to throw that deep ball. If they've been sitting back, I might sneak a draw on you.
They stop him cold. Maybe gets a yard to the 34.
And sticking to the run. I tell you what, a lot of teams that are really good are really stubborn, and they continue to run the football even with little success. So this offense is going to continue to focus on running the football, you can tell.
Better find the ear plugged. Here comes the noise, backing this defense on third down. Might be looking to run. Going to try to get it himself. Gets down with the slide.
Yeah, I think you're just seeing the experience this guy has, right? He's so poised that initially he's flushed out of the pocket, nothing's open, and he doesn't panic. He's not throwing it away. He's not sliding early. He just knows where the defense isn't. And he's able to attack that space with his speed and get a positive play.
Fourth down, and the punt team sends it the other way. Signals for the fair catch and makes it at the 20. The Tide offense rolls onto the field. How about that blocking up front in that running game last time as they just walked it down for a touchdown, David?
And the big boys up front doing their job, opening holes, the backs making plays, everything on the ground on that first drive worked.
And we know that this is the identity this coaching staff wants for this team, right? They want to be the most physical team on the field. Let's see if they can keep it up.
Picked up 2 yards on that last one. They need 8 on second down. They'll run play action. Feeling some heat. Works the middle of the field. All the way out to the 37-yard line. It's a gain of 15. Every good quarterback is first a game manager. At Alabama, that used to be sort of a label of derision, but now they're not only that, they're playmakers.
Yeah, and it's what they used to ask them to do. Like they were very comfortable handing the ball off, running the ball, controlling the clock, you know, trying to keep your defense fresh. Now, if you can't score points now, if you can't get first downs and go get me touchdowns, you're not going to be on the field.
Well, the defense knew coming into this one it was going to be a physical game. Guys are going to have to be great at the point of attack and get off blocks and make tackles. They couldn't stop the offense from picking up that first down on that one play.
The Tide with the first and 10. Gets it out quickly. Just a solid stop by this sophomore.
Defense, man, it helps you a lot when you can be a linebacker or a corner or safety, anybody. You see the QB throw the football. Now I can break up the football right away and limit gains like right here on this play.
After trying the running game on first down, they come to the line on second down. Hand off from the shotgun. Wrestled to the ground after picking up the first down. You'll hear it in the crowd a lot, yelling to the offensive coordinator, run the insert expletive ball. Well, I think the Tide might have found his next home run hitter to run the ball.
Hey, I mean, if this guy's going to have this much success, yeah, feed him the rock. Give him the ball early in the game, setting the tone. Listen, we know how it works. You get first downs and you run the ball like you have effectively early in the game. It opens up everything else and the whole playbook becomes wide open.
He stopped just a chain link or two away from the first down and sets them up beautifully here. And here comes the offense on second down. Leaves it with the back. They get him on the ground, but it's a first down. It's the two-minute warning, and we'll see if the offense can tack a little something extra on their lead before the break. The offense down to the 22 on first and 10. Looking for a man. It's Milroe. Wide open downfield. And that's where they'll mark him, but a chunk play, and they pick up a first down.
This offense has become a first down machine, and that is so demoralizing for the defense, especially for those star players that are playing tons of snaps. They're not subbing out as much. By the fourth quarter, they are going to be gassed.
Looking to throw. Going for 6. Snagged in the end zone. Touchdown, Alabama!
I'm going to spread you sideways. Sideline with all my speed, make you cover the whole field. Nice job by the offense, going with a little spread look, taking advantage of the speed they had on the field, and getting the big touchdown.
They'll try to add another to their lead. And with the extra point, they're now up by a touchdown and a field goal at 10. So it's an 80-yard drive, and they finish things off with an 8-yard toss for the score. Lining up to cover the kick after that touchdown drive. And he'll just take a knee, and this drive will start at the 25. Mizzou has it back in the offense coming out on the field. Getting late here in the first half, they'll have a chance to make this a one-possession game.
And the offensive play caller here has to really be dialed in. It's important, down two possessions, Dave, that they're able to score some points. So you got to call your best stuff in this two-minute situation.
And it's such a good opportunity to cut into a one-score game, create that momentum, get some good juices going for the second half. Because obviously, you know, you built yourself a little bit of a deficit. You need some good things to happen, and it needs to happen on this possession.
On the run, it's Cook. The quick out. And midfield, he's got room. He's run out of bounds, but a big play on that one, and it'll be a first down. It's great to send that blitz and get the heat on the quarterback, but you might need a little help on the backside with this guy.
Yeah, because now you're putting your guy in man-to-man situation against an elite receiver, and that's a tough battle to win. But you got to take those chances. You got to be aggressive. The offense won that one. At least it wasn't a huge game-changing play.
It's complete. Put it right on him. Sweet play. Good pickup, and they'll move the chains with the first down.
Well, it's a nice play design there. You're getting the running back involved in the pass game. Quarterback gives it to him early so he can go to work upfield and get the first down.
Missouri gets to the line quickly. Looking to go up top on first down. He makes the catch. Right on the money with that throw. The defense was there, but they are in the red zone with a first down at the 12.
How nice is it in this offense to have your best receiver playing in the slot? You're matching him up against linebackers, against safeties, or nickel corners. Nickel corners are oftentimes the defense's third best cornerback. This guy is virtually uncovered.
They've got it down to the 3-yard line. Really well done on that throw and catch.
This defense is going to have to be careful. Not only do they have to worry about this guy running the football, but they've got to keep their eye on him when he runs routes too. He is a versatile back.
From the gun, they'll try to impose their will. He's dropped behind the line of scrimmage. That'll be a loss of 3.
And you got to get locked in the red zone. A lot of defense coordinators will tell you, we'll give up yards, but we got to understand what we're trying to get accomplished. Great job down here near the goal line. This defense bowing their neck up and getting a big stop.
Looking to throw, it's Cook. Bought a little time, lets it go. He looks that one in nicely. And boy, is he close to that first down, maybe just a couple of inches short. We've got a timeout in the waning seconds of the half, maybe a chance to get off a couple more plays. So they are denied a touchdown on this drive, but they'll try to put up a 3-spot before the break. This is a short kick, but the problem is the angle. Oh, the attempt is no good. The missed field goal leaves us with a double-digit game, still sitting at 10.
Well, that's one the kicker would like to have back. That's a kick he should be making in his sleep.
So the offense has done its job. They have the lead, and they'll secure it as we head to halftime. And they don't want to risk a turnover here, so they'll just take the knee and head to the locker room. We've played 2 quarters here. Time to go to Kevin Connors in our halftime update.
Fellas, you've been calling a great one today from there in Tuscaloosa. And we'd be remiss if we didn't start this halftime report by acknowledging the sparkling play of this tight end. The guy's like an aircraft carrier out there as a blocker. And then when he releases and shows off that speed and route running, he's almost unguardable. Gotta believe he won't be able to go anywhere in this second half without someone attached to his hip. And with that said, let's send it back to the guys at Bryant-Denny Stadium.
Missouri will kick it off to open this second half. Here he comes from inside his own 5. He was looking for some running room, but not much to be found as he stopped at the 18. Here comes that Alabama offense. If it's working, why change it? And that running game was working in the first half. I imagine we'll see a lot more of it here in the third quarter.
And you just...
It's a fumble! defense coming up with a huge fumble recovery. And he's brought down, and this defense gets the ball back for its own. I guess in this case, the scramble giveth and the scramble taketh away, and the ball was taken away.
And I'm not sure if he just didn't see an open guy downfield or if his receivers didn't do a good enough job on the scramble rule getting open. But at the end, quarterback held on to it way too long. That allowed the defense to catch up to him and create the takeaway.
Boy, this is just the type of field position this offense wants. They're going to open this drive with a pass. Finds his big tight end.
I'll tell you, when you've got a tight end like this, it makes it a lot easier calling pass plays on first down, even if the defense is in zone coverage. He did a really good job there, working his leverage, finding the soft spot, making it an easy completion.
Let's see what they've got on second down. Gonna run it. It's Carroll. Brought down to the ground, but he has enough for the first down.
It's hard to stop great runners. It really is. That's why you run the football consistently. You got a big offensive line, a big physical unit. You run the football like this, man, it will take a toll later. But you got to tackle this guy over and over again who has this ability to make people miss and make big plays.
From the shotgun, they'll run it. Really nice run there. Good, solid pickup, and they'll move the sticks with a first down.
First down, you know you always want to establish the running game. How about this offense? Nothing fancy. Run the football. Be physical. Get a big game.
This offense trying to quiet the crowd on first and goal, and they are not cooperating. They'll try to get it in with the run. He works his way all the way down to the three, and the defense is reeling. Run, but they're going to throw it. He caught it. Takes it to the house. Touchdown, Tigers. Sometimes we ask coaches about halftime adjustments, and they go blah, 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 blah. And then sometimes they make some good ones.
Sometimes that blah, 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 blah actually works, but it's working now. But it might be too little too late, but at least you got the party started.
Ready to try the point after. And the PAT will draw them 1 point closer. A very efficient five-play scoring drive. And close the deal with a 3-yard touchdown run. They're lining up to boot it away. He'll bring it out. It's Bernard. Didn't find any crease in that kickoff coverage, and he'll be stopped at the 17. The Tide offense rolls onto the field. That last fumble proved to be costly as they cashed it in for a touchdown.
Yeah, and so this defense now is juiced. They're excited and ready to go. So this offense, David, they've got to get something going.
Yeah, those turnovers can be contagious, man. It gets you excited, and then when your offense takes it down the field and does something with it, this offense better be ready to play against a motivated defense.
Halfway there on first down, it's second and five. Here's the handoff. And they try the middle of this defense, and that is not happening.
As an offense, you've got the lead, you've had success running the football. You hope that this play is just a blip, because you know you're going to have to lean on your bell cow running back to ice this game and close it out.
Trying to move the sticks on third down. To the air, it's Milroe. He finds a soft spot in the middle. They make the stop, but the sweet rolling catch is plenty to give him a first down.
It's all about critical downs and distances on defense. You want to be great unit defensively, you've got to be good on third down and in the red zone. For this defense, giving up a third down like that, that is just a gut punch.
Red pass, it's complete. Still on his feet at was on his way. Gets it all the way to the 38.
It's a really nice looking throw. This dude is a weapon in this offense at the quarterback position. It's so funny. You know, I think back to guys like Greg McElroy and A.J. McCarron, guys that may or may not have unfairly been tabbed as game managers. And then you think of Jalen Hurts, Tua, and Bryce Young in recent years, and just how dynamic and versatile these guys were at the position and how they've really helped take this offense to the next level. Watching this guy reminds me a little bit of that.
And you want to talk about gang tackling. Everybody on the defense, run to the ball.
That's a really good job by the defense, wrapping them up, getting them on the ground. Take away that run game. Make them one-dimensional, put them in passing situations. Really good job by the defense.
After picking up a couple at 2nd and 8. He'll try to pop the draw. Little too soft in that run defense. He picks up 4 to the 32.
Well, this offense came into the game knowing they wanted to be physical, they wanted to establish the line of scrimmage, and they're running downhill right at this defense. They're churning out positive yardage early.
After the last run, would you just give it to him again on 3rd down? From the gun, wants to pass. Got it in the middle, it's Bernard. And he'll run it into the end zone. Touchdown tie! The offense flexes its muscle a bit and widens the gap.
Take a little exhale. You know, you did your job. You got points. Now you put your defense in a position where, hey, go out and get another stop. We're in great shape. So the offense definitely taking care of their business.
He'll try to tack on one more. And the extra point will tack another one onto this lead. So a drive there of 84 yards. And they cap it off with a 32-yard touchdown pass. They're just about ready to kick it away. He'll bring it out. It's Johnson. Not nearly as much as he'd hoped when he brought it out of the end zone. He'll be stopped at the 15. Missouri has the offense ready to go on the field. The deficit here is just 10 points, David, so a chance to answer here.
Plenty of time left in this football game. No need to panic. This offense just has to put a couple drives together. And listen, the defense will get this back and get some stops forward and get you the football back.
And I think here too, David, you have an opportunity to keep the pressure on the opponent. Yeah, they just went down and scored, but you score here, and this game's still tight. You keep their feet to the fire, so an opportunity here to keep applying that pressure.
Got the first down and more. And he's brought down after a nice game.
And that's all you want, right? You want that first down. Understand the situation. Understand I got to get north and south. Get a first down. Get a new set of downs.
Setting up for a 1st and 10 from the 26. They'll go to the ground. Makes his man miss. Gets it across the 30 to the 31. A pickup of 5. Halfway there on 1st down, it's 2nd and 5. Softened him up with a run and now to throw. Fires to the tight end. They get him on the ground after he gets enough to move the sticks.
Well, they pick up the first against zone coverage. I think a big part of this for young quarterbacks out there is if you're going to be throwing into zone coverage, you got to throw on time. You can't stare down receivers because the entire defense has their eyes on you, so you can't telegraph where the ball's going. You've got to hold it to the very last possible second. Try to freeze defenders with your eyes and then throw the ball into open.
Throw to the sideline, and it's complete, and they've got a big play.
Well, Reese, you and I were talking about this before.
And it looks as if they've buzzed down. Replay wants to have another peek at that last play. And the play will stand after the replay booth just does a little double checking to make sure. Wide receiver shows motion. He'll come out throwing on 1st down. Caught in the backfield, it's Burton. And they'll finally get him down after a terrific pickup.
And when this quarterback is in a rhythm, this offense is really hard to stop. You've seen that on this drive. He's 3 for 3, but they're also running the ball well. Everything they're dialing up right now is working.
They've hit him with back-to-back chunk plays. Now it's first and goal. They'll try to get it in with the run. Dragged down at the 6 after a pickup of 2. Offense trying to pay it off on 2nd and goal. The run up the middle, trying to power to the goal line. He bullies his way all the way down to the 5-yard line.
And this offense trying to be physical inside the 5-yard line. I get it, but I tell you what, Palmer, this quarterback has earned some trust from me with the day he's had.
Yeah, right now he's thinking, put the game in my hands. I'm playing well, and I'm seeing the defense well. I see what they're doing from a coverage standpoint. Count on me to throw a touchdown here and help out.
And he will be sacked at the 6-yard line. Just a great job defensively, making him go through his progressions, and he really didn't have time to do it.
And that's exactly what you do in zone coverage. You drop in your spots, you read the quarterback's eyes, make sure you take away that quick stuff, and a great job rushing the passer and getting the sack.
And on 4th down, here comes the field goal unit. And this one shouldn't be too taxing, a 23-yard try. It's good. He could have hit a string right in the middle of the uprights there. After putting up a 3-spot, the kickoff unit set to go. He'll start the return inside his 5. He was hoping for something a little more dynamic, but they get him on the ground at the 20. Here comes that Alabama offense. That last touchdown drive was surgical through the air, Jesse.
It sure was, and that's why this offense is so dangerous, David, because they can score in a hurry because of how efficient they are throwing the football.
And welcome to modern college football. That's what it is. Spread you out, find my playmakers, make quick decisions, and really put defenses in a difficult situation.
After getting knocked back to open this drive, it's 2nd and 12. Off the bootleg to buy a little space. Can't hang on. It's incomplete, and you can't worry about the footsteps when you're running those crossing routes. It'll be 3rd down.
And you got to put that one on the receiver. That's just a flat-out drop. That's a good throw by the quarterback. That's a catch that receiver needs to make.
This defense has kept them backed up. Now one more stop, and they can get off the field on 3rd and long. Back to throw. It's Milroe. It's caught downfield. And another big game for this offense. They are putting explosive pass after explosive pass up in this one.
This is exactly why 3rd down is practiced every single day. 3rd and short, 3rd and medium, 3rd and long. It's money down for a reason. You got to lock in. Great success by the offense so far in 3rd down.
Alabama quickly back to the line. Off the play fake on 1st down to throw. Grabbed in the middle. It's long. Lowers those pads. Touchdown, Bama! And they add 6 more to the board with that trip to the house. This is like a baseball pitcher that can't miss. He is just pounding, pounding, pounding the strike zone.
Man, it just gets in the zone, right? When you can't miss, you've seen quarterbacks get like that. No matter what they do, they're on fire. They're hitting the receivers. And listen, that's also on the defense. The defense has to do a better job making him feel uncomfortable, changing what they're doing in coverage so he's a little bit confused. You can't just let him pick you apart.
lining up to add another. The kick is up and good, and put one more on the lead. Quick work on that scoring drive, just four plays. And they cap things off with a touchdown pass from 59 yards out. Just about set to kick it away. He'll bring it back from inside his five. Mizzou has it back in the offense coming out on the field. This is when the pressure can ramp up a little bit on an offense, David, when they start feeling the heat to answer a score.
And I think being down 14, you can kind of feel that way. But, dude, if you put a good drive together, this is a seven-point game, so Palmer, no need to panic.
I was just going to say, David, I mean, this thing can flip quick. You go down, score, all of a sudden your defense gets a stop, or who knows, better yet, gets a turnover. This game is entirely different.
8-yard pickup on first down leaves them with second and short. Single back formation, and they give it to him. And he's brought to the ground, but not before he gets enough for the first down.
And David, how demoralizing does it have to be for a defense when you know they're going to run it, everyone in the stadium knows they're going to run it, and still you cannot stop it?
There's nothing more demoralizing as a defensive lineman, because it ticks you off. It gets in your head. You know that guy's going to come off and smack you, and you got to do something about it.
And it's on the ground. And the defense grabs it, and they're kicking it the other way.
As a defender, you dream about those big hits. You work hard on it, practice closing space, getting close, and just sticking that guy and causing the fumble.
The Tide offense rolls onto the field. That last drive, really productive. David wound up with a touchdown. They'll try to do it again.
Yeah, so I don't expect this offense to change too much, Reese. They had a great drive. They got the touchdown. Everything working. I would expect them to keep pushing this ball downhill.
And just imagine if they could put another touchdown on the board right here. They could capture so much momentum in this game with back-to-back TDs.
The incompletion on first down. Now they face a second and 10 from the 31. From the gun, the running back tries to hit the hole. Not a whole lot of room to run. Let's give him a couple. Defense getting stingier in their own end of the field. It's third and long from the 28. Moving the running back, forcing the defense to adjust. Going for it all. Makes the grab in the end zone. Touchdown, Crimson Tide.
And this receiver is on fire. He's got all the skills that you look for in a big-time target. And that's already his second touchdown of the game.
Lining up to tack one more onto that lead. And with the extra point, they push the lead out a little further. Quick strike offense on that three-play scoring drive. And the score comes on a touchdown pass covering 28 yards. The kickoff team on the field as they'll send this one away. On the run from inside his own five. Didn't find any crease in that kickoff coverage, and he'll be stopped at the 17. Missouri has the offense ready to go on the field. They're down by 21 points, but you get a touchdown here, and you do at least apply a little game pressure, Jesse.
It's true. I think for them to get back in this one at this point now, they need the quarterback to play his best football. He's going to have to be good really pre-snap, David, making sure they're in the right looks, and he's got to be really good with his decision-making.
He's got to be dialed in, because defensively you're giving up points. So it's not like you have the luxury of a defense playing great. The offense is going to have to score, and score pretty dang quick.
So Alabama takes the lead into the quarter break. They built a comfortable lead after three quarters of play. Let's take a look at how we got here. As we start the fourth quarter, it'll take a pretty sizable comeback to win this one. Here comes the offense on second down. Back to pass, it's Cook. He finds his man.
A nice job by the QB there, timing out that drag throw. It's zone coverage, so he's got to make sure he gets it to his receiver in a window to allow him to catch the ball and then turn it upfield.
So they're facing third and short from the 25. They'll try to pick up the first through the air. Complete to the left. And they'll spot it at the 45. That's good enough for a first down.
Well, I think on that play you saw why this guy's such a big weapon in this offense. At receiver, he does such a nice job with his routes. He's patient and he's consistent and he's got good hands. You don't see him put a lot of balls on the ground. Nice job there picking up the first down.
Got the first down and more. And he's bounced out of bounds, but not before a very productive pickup.
Well, this guy's a weapon, throwing it and running it, and you know he's going to try to hurt this defense with his legs.
It puts so much stress on the defensive line to chase him and the fact that the play is extended so long.
Yeah, if they've got a spy defensively, if someone's athletic enough to run with this guy, that's going to be maybe a sound move moving forward schematically.
And this will be incomplete. A big hit there forces second down.
This defense has a lot of speed, especially in the secondary. You saw that speed. That defender got to that receiver so quick, and because of the hit, incomplete pass.
Really need positive yards on second down. After the incompletion, they'll snap it from the 44. Misfired on the last play. They'll go back to the air. Got it in the middle. It's Miller. There to make the tackle, but the big throw is good enough to give them a first down. Good job by the receiver there not to run into coverage, but to find a spot that the quarterback could throw him the ball.
Yeah, on those types of routes, Reese, they say if you're looking, you're booking. So if that's man coverage, the receiver's staring at the quarterback all the way across the field. That time, the receiver didn't give the quarterback his eyes, so they were on the same page. They both knew it was zone, and they executed that perfectly.
And the big tight end, a lot of times that's a bigger strike zone, a bigger dude, and you can tell they put the hit on him, and that ball came out, and it came to the turf. Nice job playing physical by this defense.
Now on second down after the incompletion. Looking downfield, it's Cook. Makes the grab. And he was just a couple of steps away from taking that one even further after the catch.
And a big key on that throw to the slot receiver, guys, is putting the ball out in front. The location of the throw is what helped that guy get extra yards after the catch.
Mizzou coming out with a fresh set of downs. They'll run it in the red zone. It's Carroll. Gets it all the way down to the 2-yard line. He was fighting for that end zone.
I think it's just too little too late, David, at this point. That's a play that they could have used a lot earlier in this game, but because of miscues, they're down by a lot late, and I don't think they're going to have enough time to claw back into this one.
Yeah, and I'm fine with you running that play if you want to do that. My goal now is with this lead, if you want to run it, so be it, but just don't give up the big plays. Let that clock continue to roll. Make him earn it all the way down the field and take a lot of time off that clock.
This offensive line better figure out a plan for this deep tackle. He is tough to block with one guy. You might want to start double-teaming him. He's going to be a problem moving forward. You saw all of his ability on that last play.
Slams it ahead. They bring him down, and he's going to lose a yard on that one.
And with the stuff there, Jesse, on second down, this little third to mid-range, you got two downs. What are you thinking here?
Maybe getting your quarterback out on the perimeter and giving him a run-pass option. See if you can get the defense in a bind.
And they'll come to the line and try to draw a little bit closer on third and goal. Trying to punch it in. And makes his way into the end zone. Touchdown, Tigers!
and I love it. I love the physicality of this offense. It's third and goal. I trust my offensive line to pave the way, give the ball to my running back, and know he's going to physically punch this thing into the end zone.
They'll try to tack one more on their score. And it's perfect. They put it in the end zone with a 12-play scoring drive and finished the deal with the short touchdown run from the two. They've got it down to a 2-touchdown deficit, trailing by 14 and about to kick it away. On the move from inside is 5. He was looking for more running room, but none to be found as he stopped at the 23. Here comes that Alabama offense. Now they need to put something together to answer that last score.
There's a lot of pressure, too, on this offense to have to execute at a high level. They've got to score points, David, but they can't go too fast because their defense right now is tired.
And I think that's the difficulty being a play caller. Like, I have to balance all of those things. My defense is a little bit tired. I can't put on the field, but I got to be aggressive because this is a back-and-forth type game, so a lot to process and think about.
Back to pass. It's Milroe. Unloads to the wideout. Makes a connection. They'll get the first down. It's spotted on the 49.
Defense just hasn't had an answer for this guy. He has been on point. This is about as good as I've seen him play at the quarterback position. And here in the fourth quarter with the big lead, he's still taking shots.
And, man, this quarterback has had a day. With that pass, he goes over 300 yards on the day. Really nice job executing, putting up some yards today. Pretty good day for the young man.
Got it behind the line. It's Bernard. They stop him almost immediately. Short gain there. Still a little ground to cover to pick up the first.
I love an offense that wants to stay aggressive. Even when you've got the lead late in a game like this, right, you still try to find your playmakers and get them the ball in space, and that is exactly what this offense is doing.
Offense gets set for second down. He'll keep it himself. Got enough for the first, and he's still going. And how much running room have they been able to find on the ground? Man, are they piling up some gaudy rushing stats.
Ooh, I like that option play. I'd keep running that, too, because it's obvious. The defense right now is really keying in on this running back. That was a big point of emphasis for them all week long in practice, and it's opening up holes now for the quarterback to run.
The give from the gun. And you can forget running in the middle against this defense.
Defense is about firing off, hitting the offensive guys, and staying in your gaps. Everybody knowing where they're supposed to be. You could tell the defense, everyone was right where they're supposed to be. Nowhere to run.
They got nothing on the last play. It's second and 10. Motion from the offense. Looking downfield, it's Milroe. Finds his big tight end. That completion takes them down to the 7-yard line, and they are ready to strike.
Well, I tell you, man, this guy's been putting on a show all game long. We've seen his decision-making. We've seen his athleticism. Because of him, they've got this huge lead in the fourth quarter. So why stop throwing it? Just keep it going when the going's good.
They'll run it on first and goal. Knocked down after a gain of 1. They'll mark it at the 6. Now the offense tries to punch it in on 2nd and goal. They'll try to add another to their lead. And the extra point splits the uprights, and they're up a full three touchdowns, a 21-point cushion in the fourth. Kickoff team is on the field. They'll try to drive this one deep. And he takes this from inside the five. Nice job by the kickoff team. Everybody stayed in their lanes, and they'll stop him at the 16. Mizzou has it back in the offense coming out on the field. They'll crank up this drive with a pass. Setting up the screen. And he'll step across the sidelines after making a good gain on that one.
Here's the deal. You're down three possessions. You know, it doesn't feel likely they're going to come back and win, but we've seen crazier stuff happen in college football. It all starts with a big completion on a two-minute drive. They'll get the momentum started in your direction.
After that last completion, it's second down. Quickly to the tight end. They make the stop, but not before they do their work up top and pick up a first down.
This quarterback has been really good today. Has been on top of it, seeing things really, really well. That pass right there put him over the 300-yard mark. That's a pretty good day.
They'll snap it from the 39, first and 10. Scanning the field, it's Cook. Tight end finds a soft spot. They make the stop after the catch, and still some work to do to pick up that first down.
You know, I know it seems like an easy pitch and catch, but for the tight end there, that route potentially changes if it's man coverage. So good job by him knowing it's zone. I'm just going to sit down. This is basically like a check down, right? We'll just take the easy pitch and catch and keep this drive going.
They're going to throw it again. Working the middle of the field, and it's complete. Tackle is made, but not until he gets the first down. That was a nice pickup running the drag route and finding that quiet, soft spot in the zone.
Yeah, drag routes not only work against man coverage, they work against zone too. If you can find the soft spot and the quarterback gets it to him early, he can turn up field. You saw that right there.
To the air on first down. Throws to the wideout. Makes the grab. And you can see the offense just feeling itself. They've got it down to the 21. Just outstanding execution, continuing to work his way back through the football.
Yeah, and everything about this route looks vertical. The comeback, it looks like it's a go. I'm thinking speed, and then he sets it down. QB puts the ball on the money, and he makes the play.
Going up top on first down. Makes the catch. It's Burden. Touchdown, Missouri! A great catch and run for six. These two have spent plenty of time together. That was almost telepathic, David.
No doubt, and quarterbacks and wide receivers throw all offseason to get on the same page. You can see he hits him in stride. That's why he gets the touchdown.
PAT unit on the field. Right down the boulevard. So that scoring drive took only six plays. And they finished things off with a 21-yard touchdown pass. They still have work to do, trailing by two possessions here in the fourth. They'll line up for the onside kick. They'd hope to get that thing bouncing around, but the hands team is able to corral it. The Tide offense rolls onto the field. Really good balance on that last drive. They mixed it up all over the place, Jesse.
Yeah.
And this sophomore able to wreak some havoc and get the sack. The pocket broke down, and the quarterback had to take the sack.
Really impressed by this pass rush, Reese. Just guys winning their individual battles one-on-one up front. They're able to get to the quarterback.
Time is on their side, and they're going to wind that play clock all the way down. caught behind the line. It's long. And a good job in coverage there as they stop it after just a few.
It's hard to have success on wide receiver screens when you're facing press man coverage because your blockers out front oftentimes can't pick them up, and that receiver gets gobbled up as soon as he catches the pass. You saw it on that last play.
Now facing a third and long. Looking to throw, it's Milroe. Fires to the wideout. Got his man downfield. Touchdown, Ty! And once he found open space, the band might as well start playing. Getting set for the point after. And the extra point splits the uprights, and they're up a full three touchdowns, a 21-point cushion in the fourth. Kickoff team has the ball teed up, and they're about ready to go. Looks like he's going to try to return it. Stopped at the 17, and he's probably second-guessing that return. Missouri has the offense ready to go on the field. This has been a really disappointing performance, David. No question about that, but they can find some positives.
Yeah, and every time you watch the tape, you know, Jesse, coaches are pointing out, look at this. This was open if we'd have just ran the details to the right route, hung on to the football. Little things can make a big difference.
Yeah, that's why they call it a game of inches, David. But I'll say this. If you're on offense, don't go on social media this week. It ain't going to be pretty after this performance. You've got to lock in. You got to take the week of practice very seriously and find those positives that you can build off, David, that you're talking about.
That pass is incomplete, and they're probably fortunate that it wasn't knocked free for a fumble.
Another hit on the quarterback. All day long, this defense has been able to pin their ears back and get after this guy, and because of that, he's never gotten into a rhythm throwing the football, and that's why they find themselves trailing here late in the fourth quarter.
To the air. It's Cook. They're trying to get to it. And the heat gets there, and they get him down. 14-yard line.
And man, is that just an indictment of the day. Your quarterback getting drilled late in the football game. This offense has sputtered. They haven't found any kind of good rhythm. They haven't done things that really gives your coach confidence and makes you want to believe in them. This offense has a lot of work to do before their next football game.
On fourth down, he'll try to toss it. Unloads to the wideout. Makes the catch. He's got enough. He's run out of bounds, but not before turning in a big pickup and moving the sticks for a first down.
Well, this offense has a ton of work left ahead of them here in this two-minute situation late in the game, but the drive off to a good start. You get the first down, you get out of bounds, you're working the perimeter of the field. That is exactly what you want to do.
The Tigers have it with a first and 10. He's going to pass. Blasted as he lets it go. Hit hard as he released the ball on that first down pass, and it never had a chance.
Trailing this much in the fourth quarter, the offense is looking for an explosive play to try to ignite them and get them back in this one, but nothing doing. Nice job in coverage.
And the incompletion brings up a second down for this offense. He's looking to throw. He's got the tight end. They immediately call timeout, trying to preserve every second they can to try to rally here late. A completion, but not quite enough for the first down. Third down coming for this offense. Caught near the sticks. It's Cooper. Quick timeout call by the offense after the play, trying to preserve every minute possible. Here comes the offense on first and 10 from the 47. He wants to throw. It's complete. brought down at the 32-yard line. Picks up 15 yards on the play and an important first down. Here's this offense with a fresh set of downs. On the move, it's Cook. Throws to the wideout. He's got it. Touchdown, Tigers! Reeled it in and just made the house call.
It's just a really nice throw. Really good touch towards the sideline on that corner route. And the receiver does a nice job catching the football and immediately getting up the field, getting in the end zone for the big touchdown.
Now they'll line up for what they hope is automatic. Hit that one with some aggression for the point after. Time is against them, still down by two scores, but they'll line up for the onside kick. They were ready for the onside kick and executed perfectly, and they secure the football. Their work here is virtually done. No need to take any more chances. They'll line up in victory formation. And with things in their favor on the scoreboard, the quarterback's favorite play in the playbook, the old kneel down from victory formation.